This forest is old, full of memory.
Orlando Bloom was a bright star of the 2000s, but he's fallen out of the spotlight since then. Hi, I'm Rob, and let's find out why Bloom's career isn't blooming anymore.
My name is Orlando Jonathan Blanchard Copeland Bloom.
The beginning of Orlando's life kind of resembles a soap opera. Let me explain. When he was 4 years old, his father, South African novelist Harry Bloom, passed away due to a stroke. But almost 10 years later, Orlando found out that Harry wasn't his biological dad. His birth father was his mother's family friend, Colin Stone. We can safely assume that it came as quite a shock to the young man. But he managed to overcome it and soon started developing a relationship with his newfound parent. Stone became Orlando's legal guardian, and the boy even started calling him dad. Before he died, Harry said to my father he wanted him to look out for my mum and for us. And he has, Orlando recalled. Later in his life, he found a reflection of this experience in one of his movies. Bloom played Balian in Ridley Scott's epic Kingdom of Heaven, and the film had a similar twist when his character finds out who his real father is. It was partly the reason why Orlando took this role. But that wasn't the only time his career reflected his personal experiences. Stay tuned to find out more. Let's get back to Orlando's childhood years. When he was at school, Bloom's mother encouraged him to take art and drama classes to overcome his dyslexia. The young man quickly became fascinated with the world of acting.
If I was an actor, I could be all of these characters and, you know, even do my own stunts, which...
So when he turned 16, Orlando moved to London to join the National Youth Theatre and to attend a drama school. Soon he got his first minor roles in British TV shows Casualty and Midsummer Murders. And then Bloom made his movie debut in the Stephen Fry film Wild. But it was only the beginning, because his breakthrough was just around the corner. He's one lucky guy. Don't believe it? Here's a proof. In 1999, Orlando was cast as Legolas in the Lord of the Rings trilogy. Interestingly, Bloom first auditioned for the role of Faramir, Boromir's brother, who doesn't appear until the second film. But the director Peter Jackson liked him so much that he offered him a bigger role as the renowned elf.
The first time I saw you, I think.
Yeah, I got that out of drama school.
Really?
That was my first gig.
The role brought him worldwide recognition. Bloom's handsome face quickly got him a lot of fangirls, and he became the sex symbol of the 2000s. But the filming process didn't always go smoothly. Once, while shooting a scene, Orlando fell off a horse and broke a rib. Luckily, he soon recovered. This incident and the scene where Legolas had to climb up the many-tusked olifant in the last film of the trilogy reminded the actor of what happened to him a few years earlier. When he was 21, Orlando tried to climb up a rooftop terrace with his friends using a drain pipe. But the pipe scaling gave away, and Orlando fell 3 stories down. Can you believe it? He's lucky to be alive. But he was very seriously injured. Bloom broke his back, and his doctors even said that he might not walk again. Thankfully, Orlando managed to recover after hours upon hours of intensive treatment and therapy. And ever since then, he has understandably been cautious about his back. Right, why wouldn't he be? Anyway, Bloom was already quite firmly established in his career, and quite soon afterwards, he got a part in another blockbuster, Pirates of the Caribbean: The Curse of the Black Pearl.
That's another giant franchise. That's all you do with franchise movies. Like, dude, you're fantastic at it.
Starring Johnny Depp in one of his most memorable roles, the film was a huge success. And it boosted Orlando's popularity even more. It seemed like he had a glorious future in acting. All the doors were open to him. He was talented and handsome, had numerous fans, and people thought that he was destined to become the next Johnny Depp.
I played the sexy elf in Lord of the Rings, also me. I played the sexy pirate in Pirates of the Caribbean, right?
But somehow, it didn't happen. But why, God, why? Wait, is it because in the same film, Johnny Depp was much more memorable as Jack Sparrow?
Will Turner, come on!
After these two blockbuster trilogies, Bloom's career started declining. He did take part in a few epics, including the above-mentioned Kingdom of Heaven and Troy, but his other films weren't that good. Their tragic comedy Elizabethtown was trashed for its undeveloped plot lines and lackluster performances. The action film The Three Musketeers was said to be lacking any genuine interest in history or literature.
It's like
Chaos.
The good thing, though, is that Bloom got to reprise both of his most famous roles. He played Legolas in The Hobbit and returned as Will Turner in the new installments of Pirates of the Caribbean. And yet, it didn't help him to return to the showbiz pedestal. Just like that, Bloom's days as potential movie star and awesome lead actor were over. But if you think about it, he isn't the first actor whose star faded after a high-profile franchise. Right now, off the top of your head, where have you seen Mark Hamill outside of Star Wars? Or Sylvester Stallone outside of Rocky and Rambo? See? I told you. So it shouldn't be surprising that Orlando didn't manage to surpass the success of Legolas and Will Turner. Oh, and have you seen one of Bloom's most recent roles in Carnival Row? Did you like it? Because even though the series was renewed for a second season, critics didn't really enjoy it. But despite it all, it seems that Orlando couldn't care less about the decline in his career. Here's what he said once. When I finished the trilogy of Pirates of the Caribbean movies, I had a gear shift and thought, I need to take a moment to smell the roses. So let's see how he got to smell the roses, meaning outside of acting. What has he been doing all these years? Well, first of all, he had a few very high-profile relationships. The first one was with actress Kate Bosworth, who became his girlfriend at the peak of his Rings and Pirates fame. They started dating in 2003 and were on and off for 3 years before splitting up for good. Then Orlando dated supermodel and Victoria's Secret angel Miranda Kerr before marrying her in 2010. A year later, Miranda gave birth to their son Flynn. But when he was only 2.5, the couple announced their separation. For Kerr, it was a hard period, and she even shared that she was depressed after their split. And Orlando said that since they had a son together, they would remain a family forever. We're going to be in each other's lives for the rest of our lives. There's no question, for the sake of our son and everything else, we're going to support one another and love each other as parents to Flynn, the actor shared. But life went on for both of them, and after a few years, Bloom started dating singer Katy Perry. She had also come out of a hard breakup with her ex-husband, actor Russell Brand. So it looked like a perfect match.
We're made for each other!
This is it!
Maybe they finally found each other to be together for the rest of their lives. Fans always hoped that they had, even though Orlando and Katy split for a year in 2018. But since getting back together, their relationship seems to be stronger than ever. They got engaged, and last year Katy gave birth to their daughter Daisy. And these days it looks like they couldn't be more thrilled about being together and parenting their baby girl. Katy shared that Orlando was a huge help to her during pregnancy and labor. After all, he's already had a kid and knew what he was doing.
They're like, oh, you've had a run at this. You know how to do this. So yeah. He's been amazing, incredible, and we're so in love and we're so grateful.
And Katy even said having a baby with Orlando was the best decision she's ever made. Well, isn't she sweet? And Orlando, well, he just loves being a dad. It's a magical time when an angel pops into the planet, he said. You know those quiet times at home, just you and the family and the little one, and nursing and just sort of being present and seeing where you can help and what you can do to nurture a little life into the world? But if you think that having high-profile affairs and fathering two cute kids was all he's been doing this whole time, you are wrong. So let's see what a good guy Orlando is. He's a UNICEF Goodwill Ambassador and part of environmental company Global Green. Bloom encourages people to use solar panels, and he also travels to support sanitation and education programs in some countries. And when he's not doing all this good stuff, Orlando enjoys mountain bike riding and yoga. Oh, and recently he also wrote a Life in the Day column in the Times.
Managing my life, which takes a village.
Twitter users mocked it big time because it didn't look too realistic. Like one person mentioned, how can he peacefully wake up at 6:30 and check his Fitbit first thing in the morning if he has a 7-month-old baby at home? The actor shared quite a few interesting things in his column, so be sure to check it out if you haven't already. But there's just one more thing you should know about Orlando Bloom. He's not done with acting. At some point after Rings and Pirates, he realized that he still had a lot to learn as an actor. So Orlando went back to basics and started playing on stage. Looks like he managed to improve his acting skills. Because a few years ago, he starred in the indie drama film Retaliation, and it received terrific reviews from critics who applauded Bloom's performance. In the interview with The Hollywood Reporter, the actor said about this role, "Now all bets are off. I want to burn the barn down with my performance. I'm not afraid of anything anymore. If there's a role and it's going to terrify me because I'll be challenged in some way, that's what I want to do." That's a good call. Sure, it's not going to be easy to get over being typecast in sword and fighting movies, but let's hope that Orlando is successful. And even if he isn't, the main thing is that even away from the spotlight, Orlando is still happy. And why wouldn't he be? He lives with a woman he loves, he's a proud father, and he's made enough money to keep smelling the roses. A $45 million net worth is something, isn't it? And it is still up to him to show us what he's worth in terms of his career. So now you tell me, should we be sorry about Orlando not getting new roles in blockbusters, or should we be happy for him? Share in the comments below and watch another video we've done about another actor Hollywood won't cast anymore, Jim Carrey, and stay awesome!